All righty, 7:24 on a Friday morning. So Ed Wallace has the new and redesigned Ram truck. It's a looker.
It definitely has a distinctive look. I am shocked by how much they were able to add on to this one for with options, Ed.
Yeah, this isn't even the limited, Tim. This is just Longhorn edition. They can go higher than that. And we do have a new Ram. When the Ram first came out, the newest generation, back in 1994, the one that looked like a Freightliner truck, great look. It drove me nuts. It was like driving a truck with no shocks, but all my friends that bought them loved them. The second generation, 2002, was very cheaply made during the Daimler days, very plastic-like interior. Well, now we've got another generation, and the last one, I said it was the best driving and handling truck out there. Car and Driver agreed with that assessment. This one's even better. Now we're going to have a couple engines, a V6 engine with an e-boost to it that puts out, I think, 305 horsepower. I went looking for the EPA certification for the mileage. It's not posted on their website. This is the Hemi that's 395 horsepower. And again, driving it down the road was just unbelievable. A lot of trucks, as they get more and more expensive, they become more like luxury cars, and this one's no exception to that. But this is the first time I drove one where I thought, this is actually as nice as a full-size Lexus. Now, the gold standard for noise level in a car is 65 dBs. That's what a Lexus LS puts out, or a BMW 7 Series. Driving in this morning, I checked the decibel level, 58 dBs going down the road. Quieter than a full-size Lexus. Now, if you'll notice the screen, it's got an iPad-like screen right in the center dash, goes up and down, oversized. Therefore, you get a lot of navigation there, but one of the things I'm going to caution you on is you have a lot of buttons in the bottom, and one of them is apps. So I counted how many apps does this truck have on it, and it was 29 different things to do. You literally need a co-pilot with you to operate everything in the vehicle. As you can imagine, lots of space in this all the way around. In fact, this one even has a full-length moonroof on it where you can open up the entire top. Going back to the back, it's got a cover on it, but it has something on your keyless entry to drop the back for you automatically, and you can get in there. So, they start a little under $32,000 plus freight, but that's not for a single cab. They only come in quad cab and crew cabs at the moment. This one is $66,935, and at that price, didn't even shock me. A lot of pickup trucks sell for that kind of money now. But remember, the Limited is actually even more. But in terms of this, I don't think you'd find a nicer drive if you bought a BMW 7 Series. With that, y'all have a good weekend.
Wow.
I'll hire you, Ed, to be my co-pilot. You can explain all those buttons to me. Great. Ed's on the radio 570 KLIF tomorrow, and his car column always in the Saturday Fort Worth Star-Telegram automotive section.
I'm so bad about that. My husband's like, what's this button do? I'm like, I don't know.